திருச்சிற்றம்பலம் புழியர்கோன் வெப்பொழித்த புகலியர்கோன் கழல் போற்றி ஆழிமிசை கல்மிதப்பில் அணைந்த பிரானடி போற்றி வாழி திருநாவலூர் வன்றொண்டர் பதம் போற்றி ஊழிமலி திருவாதவூரர் திருத்தாள் போற்றி திருச்சிற்றம்பலம். So today we are continuing Sambandha Thevaram Padigam 1.23. We have seen the first three songs last time, so we are continuing from the fourth song onwards. So Madhuri, you can repeat with me.
Sure.
தழுக்கொள் பாவம்
தழுக்கொள் பாவம்
தளர வேண்டுவீர்
தளர வேண்டுவீர்
மழுக்கொள் செல்வன்
மழுக்கொள் செல்வன்
மரிசேர் அங்கையான்
மரிசேர் அங்கையான்
குழுக்கொள் பூத
குழுக்கொள் பூத
படையான் கோலக்கா
படையான் கோலக்கா
இழுக்கா வண்ணம்
இழுக்கா வண்ணம்
ஏத்தி வாழ்மினே.
ஏத்தி வான்மினே.
So in this song is it's more of a upadesam to us. You know, he's saying that, you know, all the karma that is attached to you, if you want that karma bondage to be destroyed or removed, what you have to do is to go to Kolaka and worship the Lord Shiva there, and that will take care of that. So that is the gist of the message that he is saying. So now if you look at the phrases and words, you will see the better idea of that. Tharukkul pavam thalara venduvir. So he is addressing the people. O men, those of you who want to be free of your karma. That is a addressing call. Pavam is a Sanskrit word, papa. Right? The papam is the one that comes in Tamil as pavam. So how is that papam? That is tightly attached to our soul, right? That is, we carry that karma with us from birth to birth to birth, so it is attached to our soul. So that tharukkul pavam, the karma that is attached to you, tharukkul means that is tightly embracing you. Tharu here means embracing. So all the karma that is tightly embracing you, for that karma, Talara venduve. Talara means to be loosened, to be removed. Venduzal means those who you want, right? Vendu is to want. So all of you who want the karma that is tightly attached to you to be removed, listen to me. I am telling you the means to be free of your karma. What you have to do? Kolakka Irka Vannam Eti Varmine. Kolakka is the name of the salam. Irka Vannam Eti Varmine. Irku means to be forgetting, to skip. So Irka Vannam means without forgetting, without fail. Eti Varmine. Eti means to praise, to worship, to stuti, to stotram. So all of you worship Shiva in Kolaka without fail and Varmine. Var means to live. Right? So that means to live means to be live happily, to live happily, to flourish. So all of you who want to be free of your karma that is attached to your soul, if you want to be free of that, what you have to do is to go to Kolaka, worship the Lord there without fail, and you will be living happily. Now in the middle two lines, he is talking about the Shiva's attributes. Marukol Selvan. Maru is the battle axe that Shiva carries, Parasu in Sanskritam. In Tamil it is Maru. So Marukol Selvan. Kol means to have. You know, you can see that in every line it has a tharukkol, marukkol, kurukkol. So kol is a verb that indicates having, holding, that kind of a meaning. So marukkol selvan. Selvan is the, selvam is Shri. So Selvan is one who is the embodiment of all riches, one who is the abode of all wealth. So Selvan, the embodiment of all wealth, the abode of all wealth, that Shiva, who is holding a Maru. So the Shiva holding the battle axe, who is the source of all wealth. Mari Ser Angayan. Mari means the baby of a deer or some other animals, right? In Indian languages, in English too, the for some animals we have special names for the babies, right? If like a cow, we say calf, right? For a dog, we say puppy in English, and for a cat, we say kitten, right? So we have some animals, we have names for the baby animals. So Mari is the name used for the young of a deer, and Shiva is holding a deer in his hand. So that's what he's referring to. Mari Ser Angayan. Anga is hand or a palm. Mari is baby deer. Ser is having, holding. So Mari Ser Angayan is the Lord who is holding a baby deer or a young deer in his hand. Then third line, Kulukul Bhuda Padayan. Kulu means a group. So Bhuta Ganas, right? Shiva has Bhuta Ganas, and the Bhuta Ganas are there. Ganam means group already. So Bhuta Ganas are generally, he is talking of the Shiva's Bhuta army. So Kulukul Bhuda means Bhuta Ganam. That's what it means. Kuru is Ganam, Bhuta is Bhuta. So Bhutas that are assembled are into big groups, multiple groups. Kuru called Bhutam, the Bhuta Ganas. Padayan, Paday is army. So Shiva has an army of Bhuta Ganas. That's what that line means. Kuru called Bhuta Padayan. So the in the song is giving three attributes of Shiva. Shiva is holding a battle axe, Shiva is holding a deer, and Shiva has a Bhuta Gana multitude. So these three is describing of Shiva, and that Shiva is in Kolaka. Kolaka is the name of this Salam, Thirukolaka. And that Thirukolaka, Yudhika Vannam Yeti Varmine. All of you worship that Kolaka without fail and flourish. So if you worship Kolaka, we will flourish. That is a direct message from Sambandhar in the song. Any thoughts or comments? We can talk. If not, Chakravarti, you can read the whole verse.
Talukkol Pavam Talara Venduvir Marukkol Selvan Mariser Angayan Kulukkol Udap Padayan Kolaka Iluka Vannam Etti Varmine.
Good. So now we move to the fifth verse. And Murthy, you can repeat with me. Mailar Sayal.
Mailar Sayal.
Madhu or Pagama.
Madhur Pagama
Eilar Saya
Eilar Saya
Eritta Endaidan
Eritta Endaidan
Kuilar Solai
Kuilar Solai
Kolak Kavaye
Kolak Kavaye
Paila Nirka
Paila Nirka
Parayum Pavame
Parayum Pavame.
Good. So, in this song, he is describing Shiva as Adhinarishwara, and he is describing Shiva as the one who burned down the three forts, and says that that Shiva is in this beautiful Kolaka. And if you think of that Shiva, think of that Kolaka regularly, your sins will be destroyed. That is the gist of the message. Just as in the previous message, he said that, you know, you go worship Kolaka without fail, your sins will be removed and you will be flourishing. And similar message here too. So, Mailar Sayal Mad or Bhagama. The first line says, Shiva having Uma as one half. That is the meaning of the first line. So, Mad is woman. Here it refers to Uma. Or Bhagama as one half. Bhagama is Sanskritam word. So, Madhu or Bhagava means having a woman as one half, Uma as one half. And as you can see from these verses, often there will be descriptive phrases describing the place, describing whatever object or describing the person. So, Uma is being described here as Mailar Sayal Madhu. Mail is peacock. Sayal means like a form. R is like. Mailar Sayal means having a form like peacock. So it's a poetic way of describing somebody is very beautiful. You know, when we want to say something, somebody is very beautiful, we take different things, right? She's as beautiful as a peacock, or you know, she's as beautiful as a parrot, or you know, she, her face is as bright as the moon. So these are poetic way of saying, describing the beauty. So, Mailar Sayal Madhu, Uma who is beautiful like a peacock. And a peacock is known for its beauty. So, as beautiful as a peacock, that kind of a beautiful Uma, you are having as one half. That Shiva, what else did he do? Yailar Saya Yeritha Yendai. Yail means fortress. A fort or a fortress. So, Yailar Saya. So, he is talking of the Tripuraris, the Tripura Asuras. And Saya means to be destroyed, to be killed. So, the three forts he destroyed by burning them. So, Yailar Saya Yeritha. Yeritha means he burnt. Eri is to burn. Yeritha is a past tense form of that. So, Yendai is our father. So, Yailar Saya Yeritha Yendai, our father who burnt down the three forts. That's the meaning of the phrase. Yailar Saya Yeritha Yendai. And he, where is he? He is in Kolaka. Tan is his Kolaka. Tan Kolakavaya. If he can worship his Kolaka. And that Kolaka is a very beautiful place. It is surrounded by nice groves. And in those groves, the various birds are chirping and singing. So he is using Kuilar Solai. Kuil is the cuckoo bird. Right? In India, they may be calling it as Koel, K-O-E-L, or commonly known as cuckoo bird. So the Kuil, R is the singing of the quill. R is to sing or to speak sound, to make sound. Soli is grove or a garden. So, quill or soli is the gardens that are where the cuckoo birds are singing. That kind of gardens are surrounding this place Kolaka. So, quill or soli Kolaka. That Kolaka, Paila Nirka. Paildal is to think. Paila Nirka means to frequently think about it. Parayum Pavame. Paray is to be destroyed. Pavam is sin. So, this is his advice to other devotees. O devotees, if you think of Shiva in Kolaka frequently, your karma will be destroyed. That is the message. Just out of the message. So he is talking of beautiful Uma as one half of his body, and Shiva who burnt down the three forts is dwelling in this nice beautiful garden surrounding Kolaka. If you think of that Shiva in that Kolaka frequently, your karma will be destroyed. That is the gist of the fifth song's message. Any comments or thoughts, questions, we can talk now. These are simple songs. The message is fairly straightforward. Short songs, direct message. So, Madhuri, you can repeat the whole verse.
Mailar Sayal Madhu Or Pagama Eilar Saya Eritha Eindaidan Kuil A Solai Kolaka Vaye Paila Nirka Parayum Pavame.
Good. How are you finding the words? Are you finding them easier or still finding them very difficult?
No, I think they are much easier.
Good. So, Pavani, do you want to read the sixth verse with me? Vedigol Vinayai.
Vedigol Vinayai.
Vitta Venduvir.
Vitta Venduvir.
Kadigol Kondrai.
Kadigol Kondrai.
Kalanda Senniyan.
Kalanda Senniyan.
Kodigol Vedavu Ar.
Kodigol Vedavu Ar.
Kolakkavulyam.
Kolakkavulyam.
Adigal Padam.
Adigal Padam.
Adaindu Valmine.
Adaindu Valmine.
Good. So this song is also is Upadesam to us. You know, like we saw in the fourth verse, he says, Tharukkol Pavam Thalara Vendivir. Like that, he is saying, Vedigol Vinayai Veetta Venduvir. He is addressing the people, all of you who want to be free of your karma. Come, worship the holy feet of Shiva in Kolaka, and you will flourish. That is the gist of this sixth song. Now we look at the phrases. Vedigol Vinayai Veetta Venduvir. Vinay is a Tamil word for karma. Veetta, veedu is to destroy. Veedudal is to kill. Veetta is to destroy. Venduvir, all of you who want to. So it's addressing the people, saying all of you who want to destroy your karma. Right? And that karma, how is that karma? Vedigol Vinay. Vedigol is here, you know, the interpretation they give that which is, you know, Vedi is in common Tamil, Vedi is to burst open. To, you know, like a crackers, right? In the Deepavali time, they have all these fireworks, firecrackers. They are all called Vedi in Tamil. So, Vedigol Vinay. This Vinay, this karma, you know, like a bomb going off, right? It goes off and destroys everything. Like that, that karma is coming to destroy us. So that karma, which is like a, you can say like a bomb. Vedi is also used in Tamil for bomb. So bottom line is that this karma comes, crack, bursts open with big noise and destroys a lot of things. So that kind of a karma, all of you who want to destroy such karma that we have, what do you have to do? He is saying that go worship Shiva in Kolaka and you will be free of that karma and you will flourish. So second line is describing Shiva's attributes. Kadigol Kondrai Kalanda Senniyan. So one word you should already know, Kondrai. Because it comes frequently in various songs. Kondrai is the name of the flower. We have seen that flower. I think I have shared the pictures of that flower. It's a tree that blooms with yellow flowers. So, Kadi is fragrance. So, Kadigol Kondrai is fragrant Kondrai flower. Kalanda Senniyan. Senni is head. Kalanda means to join, to have. So, Kadigol Kondrai Kalanda Senniyan means Shiva who wears the fragrant Kondre flowers on his head. That is the meaning of the second line. So he's describing Shiva's holy form. Shiva wears Kondre flower on his head. And where is that Shiva? He is in Kolaka. And how is that Kolaka? Kodigol Viravar Kolaka. So the Kolaka is describing as Kodigol Viravu R Kolaka. Kodi is flag. Or in commonly in other Sanskritam it's called Dvajam. Kodi is a Tamil word for that. Viravu is Vira. Vira means festival. Right? When we have a big festival in India, you know, like there will be a lot of celebrations in the going on. So Vira is festival. So Kodigol Vira. So when they have a festival, there will be a lot of flags flying. Right? They, even in the temples when they have a festival, as you know, there is a Dvajastambam in the temple. In most temples they have Dvajastambam. And they will hoist a flag on the Dvajastambam. They will hoist a flag on the flagpole whenever there is a big festival. And similarly, people also used to hoist flags in their houses. Right? It is a common sight in West especially. You know, if you come to America, you will see that, you know, every car dealership will have a national flag. People will be flying a national flag on their car, on their house. So everywhere there are flags. I'm just giving it as an example. Like that, in India, in those days, when they have festivals, people will be flying flags in many places. So that kind of Kodigol Vira. So they have festivals with a lot of flags. Kodigol Vira, Viravu, R Kolaka means R is having in many, having many or having multiple. So the Kolaka is full of flags hoisted for festivals. That means there are many festivals that are happening in Kuthiru Kolaka. And when the festivals happen, people hoist, you know, set up tents, they will hoist flags, and a lot of neighboring towns and villages, people will come attend the festival, and there will be a lot of charity work going on. People will be giving free food, people will be giving free gifts, because the devotees who come for the festivals, everybody wants to give something, right? Dhanam, dharmam, all that will happen in those kind of festivals. So Kodigol Viravar Kolaka. So this Kolaka is such a nice Kolaka salam. In this Kolaka, Kolakavul Yam Adigal, our Lord. Adigal is, Adi in Tamil is the Padam. The word Adigal refers to the God. So the Swami, in Tamil the word for Swami is Adigal. So even in the Sannyasis, right, they are called like XYZ Swami, right? So they are called ABC Adigal in Tamil. So Adigal is the Tamil equivalent word for Swami. So Kolakavul M Adigal, our Lord, our Swami in Kolaka. That Swami, his Padam, Adigal Padam, his holy feet, Adaindu Valmine. Adaidal is to surrender, to worship. Valmine, Val is to live. Here it means live happily, flourish. So what is he saying? Just the message in this song. Oh people who want to be rid of your deadly karma, what you have to do is to worship the holy feet of the Lord of Kolaka and you will flourish. That is the gist of the message, sixth song. Any questions, comments, we can talk.
Vidigul vinayai veettu venduver.
Veetta venduver.
Veetta venduver. Kadigul kondrai kalanda senniyan. Kudigul vilavu ar kolakavul em adigal padam adaindu valmine.
Good. So now, seventh verse. Chakravarti, you can repeat with me.
Yeah.
Niralar solai.
Niralar solai.
Neela vandinam.
Neela vandinam.
Kulalar pansai.
Kulalar pansai.
Kolakavulan.
கோலக்கா உளான்
கடலால் மொய்த்த
கடலால் மொய்த்த
பாதம் கைகளால்
பாதம் கைகளால்
தொழலார் பக்கல்
தொழலார் பக்கல்
துயரம் இல்லையே
துயரம் இல்லையே
குட் So again, this song is his Upadesam to us. So what he is saying is that the Lord who is in Kolaka, if you worship his holy feet, then there is no suffering for you. That is the gist of the message. And he is giving description of Kolaka. The first two lines is describing the natural beauty of Kolaka. And the third line says, Shiva's holy feet, and the fourth line says, those who worship have no fear, no suffering. So, Niral or Solai, Solai is gardens and groves. Niral is, it has multiple meanings, but here you can take it as a shade, right? When there is a dense grove, there is a lot of shade around. So, Niral or Solai, you can take it that way. That these are dark groves. So, the dark groves, you can take it as dark because of the shade, or you can also take as bright, right? Niral also means light. So, these are very nice looking. You can take it that way too. So, there is a sometimes in these verses the words have multiple meanings and you have to more than one meaning can make sense. In which case you can look at it from multiple perspectives, or sometimes you can choose which one appeals to you more. You can take it that way. Or sometimes there are two or three interpretations possible and you take the most appropriate interpretation. So Niralar Solai, that kind of a very nice, dense groves and gardens. There are a lot of flowers. And because there are a lot of flowers, that attracts a lot of bees and beetles and other insects that buzz around and drink the honey. And when the bees are buzzing around, you hear this buzzing noise, and that buzzing sound is very soothing, almost like music. You know, if you been in a garden, you can, when you hear a bee buzzing around, it will say bzzz, zzz, mm, mm. It'll like different tones will come out as the bees hover, dive, sit down, fly from flower to flower. So all kinds of things will be there. So he's describing that sound. He's describing the groves. He's describing the bees. He's describing the sound. Neela vandinam. Neelam is dark, right? Often we use the word neelam in today's language to refer to blue, but traditionally the word neelam refers to dark. So that can mean black, dark, dark blue, any kind of dark shade is neelam. So it can be dark gray, it could be dark blue, it could be generally dark, it's all neelam. So neela vandinam, so black bees, right? Black beetles. So those kind of bees and beetles, dark bees and dark beetles, they are all buzzing around, and they're making this buzzing noise, and that buzzing sound is very mellifluous and soothing like music. So he's describing the second line, that sound of those bees. Kudal ar pansai. Pan is a Tamil word for ragam. Kudal is a Tamil word for flute. R is like. So they make the buzzing sound that is sweet like a ragam that is coming from a flute. Like a music that is coming from a flute. These bees are making such nice music. Kudal R pan. Like music from a flute. Sai. Sai means making. So the Neela Vandinam Kudalar Pansai. So the dark bees are making flute-like music. that kind of a groves are there. That groves are surrounding this Kolaka. In that Kolaka is there. Kolaka Ulan. Ulan is he is, he dwells in that Kolaka. So first few lines is describing Shiva is in Kolaka, that is beautiful, surrounded by dense groves, where dark bees are humming wonderful music. That's the first two lines. And the next line is talking of Shiva's holy feet. Kalalal moitha padam. Padam is Sanskritam word feet. And kalal is a ornament that men wear on their ankles as a symbol of their valor. We have talked about that in other songs. So kalalal moitha. Moitha means to surround. So the Shiva's ankles are surrounded by this kalal. So that is what he is referring to. Kalalal moitha padam. Shiva's holy feet where he is wearing, which is encircled by the avaranam kalal. Now that holy feet, what do we have to do? Kaigalal todal. Means kaigalal means with our holy, with our hands. Todal, todal means to worship. So kaigalal todalar means those who worship with their hands. Pakkal, near them. Pakkam is a commonly used form. Pakkal is also the same meaning, near them, right? On their side, next to them. Tuyaram illaye. Tuyaram is suffering and distress. Illaye, there is nothing. It is not there. So just as those devotees who worship Shiva of Kolaka with their hands, they will have no suffering or distress. Because Pakkam is near them. So the distress will come nowhere near them. So they will be free of all suffering. That is a message that he is saying in the 7th verse. Any thoughts or comments, we can talk. If not, maybe Rama, you can read the whole verse.
Okay. Niralar solai neela vandinam, kulalar pansei kolakka ulan, kalalal moitha padam kaigalal, thoralal thoralar pakkal tuyaram illaye.
Good.
திருச்சிற்றம்பலம் திருஞான சம்பந்தப் பெருமான் அருளி செய்த திருக்கடைக்காப்பு. தலம் திருக்கோலக்கா. பண் தக்கராகம். திருச்சிற்றம்பலம்.
மடையில் வாழை பாய மாதரார் உடையும் பெய்தி கோலக்காவுளான்.
உள்ள
இழுக்குள் செல்வன் மரிசேரம் கையான் உழுக்குள் பூதப்படையான்
So with that, we will conclude today's session and we will continue next session with the remaining songs. Thiruchitrambalam.